Fridge is a very international production. Yes, it's a national show. Yes, it's a very local show. They speak local. They are very, very, you know, trenched in the local dialect. But we are in a global world. So when I talk Arabic content, it's a content that speaks in Arabic. It has the soul of Arabia. But I don't have to wait for 500 animators to be born in Dubai so I can realize my dream. No, I'll go to the best place that can give me the quality I'm looking for and for the price I'm looking for. So if you look at where things are happening, scripts are written in Dubai. Concept art and character design and storyboarding and animatics are part of pre-production. And in the first year of Fridge, all of that bucket was done in India. Now, we have a strong enough team to actually work on this in Dubai. So I have a very nice and strong pre-production team, concept art. They make the characters, they create the location, they draw them, they color them. Sound and music recordings happen in Dubai. All the recordings are here. The music composition is actually made by a Norwegian guy in London. Again, so this is infusing different things into Fridge. Modeling and rigging depends on which episode. I have 15 episodes that I split to 7 studios. In India alone, we have 5 cities working on the show, plus Singapore and France. So again, it's very hard for them to learn, you know, the gestures of Arabian women, how they walk, how they do. But once they learn that, you can actually get more for your money, basically. Because again, you need to look where it's cheap and to the quality. And it's your job as a director and your team job in pre-production to make sure is the quality of the show is met. And for season 4, we really jumped the quality because Fridge is always looked upon as something that might be inspiring. It will come up with the new thing. From the day we launched, we were ahead of the competition and we wanted to stay there in terms of quality. Post-production is in Dubai and animation, as I said, is done in different places. Okay, I talk to many people, they think I'm an animator. I can't animate to save my life. This is not my, I've studied animation and I know the theory of animation. I tried working on the program, but I am not an animator. I am not to be referred to as an animator. I am a director. And a director is very different than an animation. You can have a film director becoming an animation director. You can have an animation director becoming a film director. You can have a story writer to be a director later. What does a director need to have? It's the knowledge and the know-how of every single department that will work under him. Enough knowledge to make a decision to change things around, and he should be somebody who can really push the entire production and the entire team to work beyond their capabilities to deliver something of quality that matches his vision. And in hope, the viewers later will enjoy that vision. Yeah? So what goes into animation? Many people, many walks of life. You can have somebody, I have somebody who lives just by storyboarding. That's what he does for a living. I storyboard. If you tell somebody here, like, what do you do? I'm a storyboarder. It's like, what? He's like, this is a job? Writing, a writer, photography. If you're a photographer, you will find a place for you in animation. Not necessarily in my company, but in animation. Directing, illustration. If you're an illustrator, if you're a music designer, if you're a sound designer, if you're a Foley artist, if you're an interior designer, for this season of Fridge, we had different sets in our show. And we said, you know what? Let's speak to an interior designer. Let's see what he can give us in terms of ideas. And we redid Umm Alawi's house, one of the houses we have in Fridge, based on the comments we got from an interior designer. Atal Khabaz Khabza, give the baker, you know. We have a saying in Arabic that saying the it's only the baker who can bake the best bread. So it's basically a metaphor to people know best. Anyway, revenues. Again, you would think that in animation or like a concept like Fridge, like my company, it makes two things. It created a TV show and it created a theatrical show. Now my TV show is one of the most watched in the UAE and in GCC. My theatrical show is the largest Arabian theatrical production. And it was hosted in our stage in 2009. But you see the small things, the small businesses that appear out of that. So you have TV shows, you have TV sales when I sell it to the TV. You have DVD sales above that. Okay, you have digital sales when I license this for online and mobile content, which I did. Yeah, then there's the mobile content. Then companies come to you and say, you know what, Mohammed, you're good in animation. I want you to do for me a commercial for my company. Not using your characters, but I want you to do, you're good in animation. I want you to direct a few commercials, which we did. Then you can go to consulting. Oh, Mohammed, you know so much about the culture now. You know so much about animation. Can you come and consult for us? That's a revenue for you. Mascots. People come to us for us to develop for them mascots. Whether it's Nescafe, whether it's Hardee's now, whether it's X, Y, and Z. People come to you because, number one, you have made a show and people like that show. Now they want to be part. They want you to be part of creating something for them. Merchandising is a huge thing. It's, we have 400 products in 11 countries, you name it, from homeware to children's wear to edible stuff, whatever. Meet and greet. And this is funny. When somebody wants to celebrate his kid's birthday in the UAE, what do they do? What do they have to show as a mascot? They will get a fake Mickey and a fake Donald Duck costumes, and they will go there and they will scare the kids off, and people pay money for that. Once we introduced the Fridge characters, then it's like cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching. People were calling us, they want us to come celebrate their birthdays. And in eight months, that part of the company managed to bring in 1 million dirhams worth of revenue, because there was a need in the market for it. There was a need in the market that nobody identified before. So you're creating markets as you go on. So don't underestimate a small product of yours saying, okay, it's an animation. But the beauty of animation, if it's done, as I said, with originality, with excellence, and with dedication, it can grow beyond the borders of what you have imagined for it. I've never imagined that Fridge will be on Cartoon Network one day. I've never imagined that Fridge will be dubbed in Malay and it will be shown in Indonesia in a few months, or Malaysia, or X, Y, Z. No, I made Fridge because I wanted to create a cartoon show for my people. But I did it with excellence, dedication, and originality that, you know, it made more people be interested in that. I was not born a director. I was actually the first ever product I directed in my life was season one of Fridge. So when you look at track record, I basically started from zero like everybody else. Some people will start directing small clips, or they will do a commercial or X, Y, Z. No, I was like, I either do it and be on the top or really fail miserably. And you know, I was lucky enough to have that idea that could be successful and could be loved by the people.